What's up, everybody? Welcome to Making Songbringer. Today, I'm still working on some story elements. Hopefully, I can get these finished before I go on vacation for Thanksgiving. I'm gonna be taking a week off here, visiting some family. What's up, Sound Dongs? So I'm trying to get these story elements finished so I can get this update out to Steam, put it up the beta update. We'll see. I might not be able to have time to finish it. There's a lot of story elements in this latest one. So what I'm gonna be working on today is the engine room. We'll go over to the engine room now. How you doing today, Sound Dongs? Yeah, those are floating servers. Servery things. Systems, servers, I'm not sure what to call them exactly. Or what they are. I just drew something. It's the WZF method of drawing. What's up, Zilton? The first thing I want to do is have the droidsmith so we can warp. Which means I'm probably going to need to copy current saves. Saves. There we go. You really should be doing homework. Yeah? Power line? What's power line? Is that a Vim thing? Status plugin. What's a status line? Oh, okay. This is homework. There you go. Awesome. Makes it look cool. There you go. Thank you. Right? I wish when you're looking at like a project, you're trying to figure out what the hell it is or it does. They would talk like you just did. Basically, it makes it look cool. Okay. Now I understand. Awesome. So let's get the Smith so he has an animation for teleporting. All right, we'll use something like this. This one's out, the other one's in. Well, I'm not sure why they couldn't just be reversed. All right, save this as Smith. Smith teleport. Hey, what's up, Ishni? Welcome to the stream. All right, let's get open. Open up the Smith idol. That's what it looked like when he's warping. Hello, Warcried. You reading up about any component systems? All right, cool. Yeah, man, it's really good to have an entity component system, I'll tell you. I will never go back to not using an entity component system to write games. It completely revolutionized the way I write games. Keeps them so organized. You can reuse code and components for everything. It's just awesome. Highly recommend it. I'm glad you're checking out Entity Foo too. Hope it helps. Zilton says he spaghettis his blueprints on purpose. You would. Ha. That's awesome. All right, how many pixels off the ground is he? It's like 5 pixels off the ground. Right. So we're gonna need a blue copy of the Smith and a red copy of the Smith. They're like impossible not to get spaghetti. I don't even write blueprints. There we go. All right, we got a red copy and a blue copy. They're so easy to arrange. Okay, we got a blue, a red. These should go beneath. We don't need. Wait. Start here. The next frame. Damn You can comment comments. So I'm gonna make this animation for the droid smith so he can warp in, and then I'll start drawing this engine room pixel art today. is 52 total, so this should be 21, 26. That's about right. And how far off the ground is he? Five, cool. Ay-yay-yay! Why does he move here? Unreal, yeah. Yep, art today. DX like DirectX? All right, so this frame, the red and the blue sneak out by a pixel. This one's 2 pixels. Wait a minute, are these somewhat transparent? No, they're not. Huh. I would have thought they would have been somewhat transparent. He looks like a coffee machine. Yeah, he makes coffee. He like fixes people's iPhone screens. That kind of thing. This one's 3 pixels. This one 4 pixels? It is. 4 pixels, whoa! The milk frother broke. Ain't that life, right? Everybody on Songbringer was so happy until the milk frother broke. He's a multitasker. He can do it all at once. See how many arms he has? He can fix your iPhone and make you coffee at the same time. Wind filters. What are wind filters? I've never heard of these things. And 1 pixel here. And here's where it gets all bright. And then even brighter. Okay, so you use bright here. What are your favorite shading effects to use with Songbringer? Well, I use a lot of custom shaders. One of them is a light shader, one of them is a bloom shader, one of them is a blur shader. One of them is a, there's a reflection shader. Did I mention the blur shader? Yeah. I don't know. I guess I like the light shader the most. Filter, blur, or distort and wind? Oh, you mean like when I'm in making pixel art? Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can do that. Like, you mean like motion blur, basically? Liquid baguette, but do his nipples receive AM and frequencies and FM? Oh, that's a Red Dwarf reference? I haven't watched Red Dwarf yet. Oh, I gotta see that. I've heard it's great. So this one will be bright. Bright. Brighten it up, man. Brighter. Not darker, brighter. That's pretty bright. Start there. And then this last one, he's super bright. Like that. Rocket Bunny! What's up, Rocket Bunny? Yeah, whatever effect does the trick. I don't really use as many of these Photoshop-y effects as much because I typically, oh yeah, here's wind. Let's try some wind. What does that do? Oh, that's kind of cool. Huh, that's neat. With the right effect, that could be really cool. Thanks for sharing that with me, Zilton. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, what happened, man? Jonah19, what's up? Oh, it's not cross. Don't won't cross the pond too well. We won't get it. I'll try it. I'll see how good it is. Hey, wait, is Red Dwarf the one where is that an? They're like. Maybe I have seen Red Dwarf. I don't remember. All good so far? Good. Right on. I'm glad you got your BIOS cleared up yesterday. Levels. Make this super bright now. Super bright. Super duper bright. Yeah, like that bright. Bam. Maybe brighter. Okay, so let's see this animation. Yeah, cool. I think this frame here, maybe like 50% or something. And I'm telling you, these red and blues should be. Like 90%. There we go. Cool. All right, we got a teleport animation. Done. Smith teleport. No shadow. No, this is me shadow. Sheets. Shadow. Teleport. Smith teleport. Render. Blam. Blah, 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 blam. You run your both your graphics cards. Oh, you can't? You might have to move to Seattle. What? Oh, you gotta wake up early in the morning? Oh, Jonah, man, don't be sorry. Thanks for all your support, man. What you been doing for work? Warcry, did you build your own animator? You mean coding the code for animation? Animator. If you mean animator, like, I'm just using Photoshop to do my animations here. And then in the code, I do have my own animation code. So it actually takes each frame of this animation, loads it all, and then plays it at its own timing. Because Cocos 2DX is kind of, I don't have as much control if I use Cocos 2DX's animations, animation code, I mean. Your mom's starting a business. Whoa. Okay, so the Smith, I think he just needs a teleport in him. Let's look at Rock's, Jib's teleport. Jibby, Jib. Teleport. Okay, so we need a teleport and a teleport in. And we'll just do Smith teleport for both of these. and just reverse it. I don't know why I wasn't using this reverse for other guys. Okay, let's see if we can teleport now with the Smith. That's probably not gonna work because I haven't coded it yet to do three. What version of PS? I'm using an old version, like 6 or something. Yeah, a texture gets loaded as a 2D mesh. Each sprite frame is... Cocos 2DX has its own sprite framey thing. You basically use a sprite packer to pack everything into one sprite sheet. And Cocos 2DX has a sprite sheet loader. Check it out. Shadow.plist, for example. So it loads it like this. It's got all these different sprite frames that it packs into one texture. Let me show you. Yeah, this is an essential tool to have as a game developer. You need to have a sprite packer. I use Texture Packer. There's other ones called ZwapTex. There's other texture packers out there. Some game engines already have texture packers built into their engine. Like I think Unity does this automatically for you. I'm not sure. But basically, see this? It packs like all 3,000 of these sprites or whatever into this one texture. And each single one of these individual sprites has a certain entry in this property list, which says, okay, this sprite in particular is at this offset and is this exact size. So Cocos 2DX loads only one texture and only has to keep one texture in memory, but it has access to like all 3,000 of these sprite frames just based on the offset within that texture. And so when you write your animation code, you're referencing, or when you're writing your sprite code, basically your sprite is referencing only a certain part of the texture. And then when you're changing the animation frame, you're just changing which part of the texture it's rendering. It's pretty simple, really. Oh, Jonah, you've been programming, huh? Well, that's cool. So does that mean you graduated, right? What happened with all that? Oh, yeah, Rocket Bunny, dang. What's up, Professional Novice? Yes, exactly. A lot more efficient, a lot more efficient. Okay, let's see if this worked. Oh, it's probably not going to work. I probably got to put some other code into the teleport phase. We can't teleport down here. That's right. All right. We'll go back to here. We can teleport from here. Yeah, Cocos does. It can swap things in and out of GPU memory, but I think for Songbringer's case, Songbringer has so few textures because it's pixel art, that it can just put it, pretty much keep it on the GPU's memory the whole time. There's really no need to swap anything. Right, so it didn't run his animation. I think because, yeah, phase, teleport in and teleport out, both of these need to loop over all of the heroes, not just the one hero. Yeah, here it is. Okay, so animate other heroes for alt heroes var name h. h.render. So it's basically making the sprite visible again for all the other heroes. And then the same thing for teleport out. Teleport out, here we go. Stop and drop, run the teleport animation. Here it is. For alt heroes, for all the alternate heroes. Oh, you haven't graduated yet? You still waiting for your results? All right. Oh yeah, sprite atlases. That's a good point, Salad Dogs. I forgot about sprite atlases. You're working on your custom RTOS? What's an RTOS? Is that like an RTS? Oh, real-time operating system. Oh, dang, man. Sounds hard. Okay, Liquid, see ya. Individual blocks of colors. I'm not sure what you mean by that. Assuming you have a single pixel texture for building your map. I'm not sure what you mean by that work, right? What you trying to ask there? You won't have to stay up till 4. My streams will be going on at exactly the same time I'm streaming. That would be crazy. You don't have to re-implement the GUI. Oh, that's good. Flux, teleport, set animation for all heroes. H.set animation. Teleport. Was there anything else in here? Da-da-da. Is it ever referencing Jib? This is where it stops and drops the cube. This is all stuff for the main hero. That's for the parent node interface, the background interface finished. I think this doesn't reference the. Huh, I thought that would have referenced the heroes. Oh well. I think that's all. What's a protocol? Well, there's protocols in Objective C. Is that what you mean? A protocol in Objective C is basically like a class. It's the equivalent of it is a C++ pure virtual class, which means that something can inherit from it, but if it inherits from it, it has to implement its methods. A pure virtual is something you can never construct. It's just more of like an interface or something like that. It's like a class declaration. It's something that defines a class that has some functions, but you can't actually create a class until you create a class that's a subclass of it. I'm kind of doing a bad job of explaining what a protocol is. If that's what you mean. Yay, he teleports! They teleport! Woo! Nice. All right, cool. Good, that's all done. That wasn't too hard. Now I can put the player back here and check this in so far. Get at all. Save this teleport animation here. Close it. We don't need any more. Don't need that anymore. Don't need that anymore. Oh, it's a hobby project. Whoa. What's new since the last beta update? You mean since last week? Well, man. This week I've only been working on story elements. It's man. Since what? When? When exactly are you talking about? Since last week or 2 weeks ago? No, I don't have any update videos on what's new. I just kind of have videos from each day of development. Cool. So now it runs the alternate heroes is teleport animations for every hero, not just Jib. And the Smith has his teleport animation. Smith could teleport. And technically, you could go get the Smith when you get the Smith quest, and you could play the whole game with Smith. He doesn't do anything, but you could do that. Okay, now I'm gonna start drawing the engine room. Does he ask him to fix his bike up? That'd be cool. Maybe that's like a side quest or something. Okay, here's where the engine room is gonna be. The first thing I want to do is create a large entity in the middle of the screen that represents what the engine will be. I'm thinking this is like a giant cylindrical type thing with some dark energy or some power in it. Reminiscent of these like lamps right here. Psylocke, are you documenting the game from day zero? I sure am. Already have been. Every day's all documented on YouTube. You can look at my YouTube channel for all that. Goes back to day one, man. The last time you were here is when we were working on the last boss. Oh my god, things have really changed since then, Jonah. Oh my god, where do I start? Nah, things haven't changed that dramatically, but yeah, there's been a lot of stuff that's been added since then. The last boss, the overworld has gotten a lot of love since then. The overworld has all these stairs. You can go upstairs, downstairs. The water has depth, so you can see like the depths of water. There's pits on the overworld too, so there's like these big old giant pit areas. The dark forest area of the overworld has all these foggy clouds. There's a lot of stuff I've been working on this week with the ship. So the ship has a bridge. Let me show you the bridge really quick. That's a pretty cool thing to see. Lots of story elements too. I'm working on the story this month, a lot of it. Oh, at the very beginning of the game, you get scanned. You get scanned by the, and there's like an extra scene where you look at this drop floating in cryo sleep. So it's a little bit better of a story. Here's the bridge. I wonder if there's any dialogue that they'll do. I think I've already done all the dialogue. Oh no, there's this dialogue. So yeah, that's cool. There's several different story elements that happen here in this room. So I'm not gonna show all those because it kind of would be a big spoiler alert. But yep, the quest I'm working on right now is where you get the droidsmith. So the droidsmith, you actually take him out of the droidsmith room, and you're supposed to go down to the lower levels of Songbringer. That's how you first get into the lower levels of Songbringer, and you have to take him to go get him and to fix some stuff. In fact, at this point, I should have dropped him off, so let's do that drop-off thing really quick. Just so the state of the game is kind of how it should be. This is where you drop him off. Yeah, the pimp hat, right? Oh man, I hope the stream wasn't messing up right when I was explaining all that. Yeah, so here's the... whoops. Here's where the smith goes and he works on servers or whatever he's doing. He's trying to fix the doors and you're trying to identify what this anomalous blip is. There's some... the ship's bridge has been picking up some weird stuff going on, so... alright, let's get back to drawing the engine room. First thing, it should be bigger, wider. It was like speedrunning, was it? Was it all like running in fast forward? I think things are okay here on this end. Yeah, the stream appears fine here. So I'm gonna go to get pattern flags for the ship engine room. So the engine room, I want it to have min wall thickness. No added lights and no edge path. So this will make this room bigger. Okay, cool. It's a little bit bigger. I should have the key to open this door too. Yeah, that's from that story element. Cool. Okay, so now I just want to do the big old cylindrical thing in the middle. How big should this be? I'm thinking at least 240 tall. And let's just make it all 420 wide, I guess. This could be huge. Huge if we want it to be. Now, a cylinder. Yeah, cylinder shape. I was just trying to think, like, should it be cylinder? Should it not? Yeah, I think so. Should probably be saved as a background. Four 20. Is it 420 right now? What? Oh man, don't even talk about 420. I can't smoke weed right now. Oh, my life is so difficult. Right, this is the engine. We'll take a circle, squash it. Let's make a background. Oh, 420. Yeah, that's my res, man. It's my resolution. Why do you think I chose that? Like maybe a little darker than this. Okay. So how big should it be? I don't know. Before I do this whole cylindrical thing and make it like a perfect cylinder, it'd probably be a lot easier to start with it just being approximately the right proportion, the right size. So let's just do a rectangle. Rectangle! Yay! How much more simple can you get? I want to make sure that engine is still, or I mean the backgrounds sheet is still going to be okay with a bunch of engine pro. Yeah, this can grow. This can be twice as wide and be totally fine. All right, we're good there. Okay. Now we need a misc tile. So the ship's engine room will have a rectangle worth of rectangle size, like static. So this is all static tiles. And then a single tile in the middle. K tile misc. And the misc tile will just know that it should be the engine inside the engine room. Oh, what's wrong with that? Oh, whoops. The block said. The power of one USB is over 9,000. Will there be concerts in the game? Yeah, there is. There's going to be a concert. There's going to be not really a concert, but more of like a little dance party going on the surface of the planet with their away ship and a bunch of party dudes. Like a Charlie Murder style. What's Charlie Murder? I never played this game. Is this what it looks like to play? Looks like it. Is this a zombie game? Uh-huh. All right. It's pretty cool. So in the pattern ship engine, we're going to do ship engine. And we'll put this in the entities. Ship systems, targets, system, ship engine, profile, no profile yet, render, an M, what was that I called this? I think I just called it engine, zero. Yeah, background's engine. Okay, so this should be engine number sign. Anim delay. We're not going to need that just yet. Collision. There we go. Now we got an enemy. Okay, so now we'll just see how big this rectangle is and if it's about the right size. What if the cylinder had rings? That either spins or goes along the length. Yeah, totally. I'll definitely do something like this. Okay. That's totally off. It's because... Oh, because I did... Let's trim this up. Trim. And then make it sort of like a... like 128 by 164 or so. Yeah, I'll definitely do something cool for the art here. Just getting the flow in here. Deciding on proportions. Right, so let's make it further down for sure. So at least WH2 minus 2 or so. We're gonna need some lights in this room. So let's try H2 minus 3. I think I want it to be surrounded by sky. Or pits or whatever you call them. So we'll do W2 minus, I'm not sure how big this should be just yet. Okay. So probably the whole thing should be sky instead of it. We need lights, definitely need lights to be able to see this. I think it'd be nice to have some of these, the edge of the screen all like etched out. This'll do that. Now we'll put some lamps. And this could have been just W2 minus 3 plus 3, only sky, H2 minus 5. I don't know what that should be yet. It worked! Yeah, Rocket Bunny! That's so awesome. I'm glad you got it working. PMC, what's up, PMC? Stream ain't ending, man. You're good. Okay, so, I guess we do need to have some regular tiles in the middle there. And, okay, this does look about the right size, the right proportion. That's really weird that it has the door lights on top. But that's kind of how they work. If they didn't, they would be too bright. Happiness over 9,000! Console? Was that a KDE thing? Okay, I'm gonna set a point for, or a center point for the MISC tile here. W2, H2 minus 3 was a little bit too much, so we'll do minus 2. So this is going to become C.X, and this is C.Y. And this is C.X minus 3. This is C.X minus 2. C.X plus 3. This is C.Y. Wait, that was H2 minus 5. Huh. I guess we're going to have to adjust this position a little bit here. Yeah, KDE, right. Yeah. Huh. Wow, tell me how it works, Saladongs. I wonder how well it works on Mac. Neither of your parents found out? Oh, lucky. Lucky dog. Yeah. So this is going to become the center point. So this can just become C.Y. Minus 3. C.Y plus 3. C.Y minus 2. C.Y plus 2. And this has a position offset. Negative 2B. And doesn't really need a collision anymore. You found a couple bugs? I'm talking to an NPC that can, their text box can get cut off sometimes. Yeah, I got that on my bug list. Okay, this is starting to look pretty good. We can go up one more pixel with it, and then these statics can stretch, or wait, the skies can stretch a little bit more below and above. Actually, maybe just one above. H2 minus 1 there. They're running KDE or GNOME within Windows? With Wine, or was it something like VMware? Or was it really just like an EXE they compiled? Now it's starting to look more like, whoa, crazy. Hidden wall. Yeah, I think this is about the right size. Oh, if this is a cylinder, it's gonna kind of look weird. What are you doing, Jib? Jib's like, there's something over here. He really wants to go over there. What is it, Jib? It's a diamond. Oh, using Ubuntu? No way. Yeah. I've got Ubuntu on Windows on my Windows partition. That's pretty cool. So to make it cylindrical or to make it rectangular? If it gets cylindrical, it's gonna look weird with the floor. Well, let's try it out. Let's see what it looks like if they have a cylinder shape there. Nice. The mission where you follow the cape guy. Possibly go back into that place and be stuck without a sword. Right? It's back into that place and be stuck without a sword. What you mean? Oh, you mean after you complete that dungeon once, the dungeon without the sword, you go back into it after that? Tell me more about this one. You should be able to, if you've already completed the swordless dungeon, you should be able to go back in and still go through and complete it again, because you'll have the meditate skill, and you just have to use the meditate skill again at the doors to get back out of the swordless dungeon. So you should be able to get out of the swordless dungeon no matter what, whether it's the first time you're getting into it and you're getting the meditate skill, or the second time you're going through it and you're just using the meditate skill again. Why didn't you make us be an early access title? This is a great question. But in short, I have a lot. I could go on for an hour talking about why Songbringer is not an early access title. Jonah, see you, man. Later. Later, dude. But to suffice it to say that Songbringer is not the right kind of title for early access. Titles that work really well with early access are like multiplayer games or games that have like tons of replay value or games that are like really quick to finish. Like you can finish the game in like a half an hour. You know, things that basically Songbringer is not a very good example of a good early access title because it has a story and it has a game that's like at least 3 hours to complete, if not 8 hours if you're being thorough. So it's just doesn't quite fit. And I think it would be wronging a lot of players to make it an early access title. So this is for the players. I want the game to be really, really good when it's all finished and and secondly, a lot of early access titles, you wonder if they're ever gonna finish them. I hate that. I don't wanna go pay into a game and then wonder if they'll ever finish it. That sucks. Sawdung brings up a good point. Like Songbringer has some pretty good replay value with its procedural nature, but the story never changes really. It may change a little bit, maybe there's some alternate story elements and stuff like that, but for the most part, it's a story that's told. And once you've already heard the story, you kind of know what's going to happen, basically. More Zelda-like than roguelike for sure. There's some roguelike elements, but really it's mostly just a Zelda-like game. Mutinous, yeah, it could be an octagon too, but what I'm wondering about this whole the whole shape of this is Songbringer uses a lot of like these square tiles and stuff. I'm wondering if that'll look weird with any kind of curve, but we'll see. I guess I could put some ground on the bottom. Yeah, actually, this could work out if I just use some ground textury stuff. So let's start with a cylindrical shape. Yeah, I don't want to spoil the plot. I don't want people to have to play a game, you know, like have to. What sucks when you're playing an early access title that does have a story is you're wondering the whole time, okay, am I gonna have to go play this again to get the whole story? Vectors. All right, here's a pretty simple shape. Just proof of concept here. See if this is gonna look all right. Oh, I guess since it's the same exact color. Not showing anything different about this. Yeah, okay. All right, looks weird, but oh well. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, I just decided I don't even want it to have I don't even want it to have any ground tiles around it. Like I want this cylinder to go straight through the floor, which means it needs to have two entities, a bottom half and a top half. Oh yeah, I can see it have tons of pipes and things like that on it. Okay, let's start with making it all sky. You bought an early access title? Oh, yeah. Yeah, sometime next year, right? And that's so indefinite. And a lot of titles these days aren't getting finished. Game developers are abandoning the title because they didn't make enough money with their early access build or something, you know? Why did you choose Cocos 3DX? Psylocke, I chose it because it's C++, it's cross-platform. Those are the two big reasons. C++, cross-platform, and it's not software. It's all source code, right? I don't like Unity or Unreal or any kind of engines like that. Even though they're great engines, Unity is an awesome engine, Unreal's a great engine, but I don't prefer them because I don't like having to run some software that builds my game. I want to be able to build my game myself using a compiler, the command line, if I really want to. Yes, gas-powered ship. Nice. Take it, man. Do it. Make it a gas-powered ship. So we don't want any static tiles at all. And we can throw the ship engine miscellaneous tile like just below. Wait, we want it to be CLY. This is -4, so we want this to be -5. And this is going to be like plus two or three. So we should have all sky there. Yeah, Rocket Bunny. You fix your lap. See? What did you learn through this process, Rocket Bunny? I'm sure you learned and grew and found something else out. Here we go. Good. Now we're starting to look like what I want it to look like. So I'm going to fill in the whole bottom of it with some cool stuff. The whole top of it with some cool stuff. And then sort of like a chamber in the middle with some other stuff. So let's center it. 2.5. Looks pretty good. Oh, what's this? Oh, that's the... What is that? Why can't I walk on that? Hold on, maybe this needs to be CLY minus 6. The boot systems are very fragile. When Wiz warns you that it's hard, be more cautious. Dang, MacPorts, take it forever. What the hell? Why is this like got one thing I can walk on there? I don't get this. Ah, it's weird. Oh, it's the secret path here. We have the secret path that goes through there, so it's creating one on this. Okay, so this can be 2.5, this could be 5. I'm just going to note this in my next things to do. This is not that important. So, Fix can walk onto sky tiles if has a secret path on ship. Okay, let's start drawing. Let's make this look cool. We're going to need a bottom half. And a top half. These might need to be separate kinds of sprites. Will kind of suck to try and draw all of this separately. Oh, wait a minute. I could just draw the whole thing. Oh, yeah. I'll just do that. I'll draw the whole... Oh, there's no need to separate these into separate sprites if I just draw the whole thing so it only fits into a certain height or whatever. So, no problem. Change the height of this. It needs to be at least... 315. And we need something to represent the bottom of this. So now I can dial in the height, which is, oh, I should be able to know the height already. I just run it. Just a bunch of discs. Okay, so if this is the right res, then from here, we'll need to do this edge like that. Unless I just draw it really so it fades pretty darkly. So that's about 18 pixels. Okay, let's see how this is looking. So now it needs to be pushed up only by one, I think. Yes. Unstoppable. Yeah, this will work. If I got one more pixel. Clean up most of the wires. Just chop all the wires out, man. You don't need wires. You don't need fuses or wires. Okay, that did look a little better with only one pixel gap. Okay. 12 it is for now. All right, let's start making this look cool. Graphics tablet to the rescue. So what should go in the inside? I'm thinking some crazy, either some crazy bright energy or, Crystals. Crystals, that's an interesting idea. Crystals could be cool. Overall colors, shapes. There's no way that a bee should be able to fly. Yeah, Zilton. Everything will communicate through ants. Ants and bees. We could have this sort of lava lampy look too. I think instead of working on the middle part, I'm gonna work on the bottom and the top parts first. Let's get a tube coming down this whole thing. Cause silver, chrome, or like. I don't know, I can work on the hue later. I'll start with just the tones. So I want to see a huge tube thing come down here and like fit onto here, kind of like a pipe. Bees create a vortex. Whoa. Eight, six, five, four, three, two, eight, six, five. Heart Machine's working on a new project. Sweet. What if the ship's being powered by a giant heart? That would be so Hyperlight Drifter, though. Can't do it. Alright, Koken. Cloning chamber? This is the engine. This is the engine, man. The engine. How many pixels I got left here? That. Oh, okay, I could do one. One more. There we go, now we got a pipe. And later on, what I'll do is I'll go back and make these a little bit cooler looking by adding some texture to the top of all these. So let's do some more pipes. Thinking a pipe that like juts or something, goes at some crazy angle. Yeah, angles for sure. Angles, asymmetrical ones for sure. So far, this isn't really like looking that much. I don't know. Something missing here. Ah, it's the shadow. Read a shadow beneath this. Around it. It booted! Yay! Yeah, everything is going to look a little too smooth until I get to the final stages of making this art. Typically, pixel art looks like that. You know, pixel art looks really smooth and clean at first, and then, I don't know, depending on your aesthetic and how you finished your art, it can really change in the last little moments and make it look so much better. That's what happens to most of my art. Like, in the very last 10 or 20% of making the art, suddenly it pops, suddenly it looks good. So this is gonna look like crap for the first 80%, I swear. But you just gotta have to have faith. That's something that took me a long time to learn when making art, is you gotta have faith in the process of making art. Otherwise, if you just give up too early, you're missing out. Yeah, especially pixel art. Yeah, that is true, right? Just a tiny little bit more and all of a sudden it's good. Yeah, hits. Everything starts blank. Yeah. What's up, Wild Chat? Today, tomorrow, or tomorrow, tomorrow. How's this looking? Yeah, you're watching from your laptop now? Yeah, the darkness helps a lot for sure, huh? The lighting usually helps a lot too, and in this case, I think it really does help a lot. No, this pipe's going underneath that pipe. How do you talk to the girl you really like? Well, the trick is getting over your initial fear. Once you can get started talking to her, it's a lot easier. So how could you maybe get started? How could you just start up, crack up a conversation with this girl you like? You have no clue? What is she into? What is she like? You freeze when you see her? What do you think she's into? What would she like to talk about? Or how could you maybe get in some kind of conversation started? Oh my God, I'm doing this the hard way. What am I doing? Biscuits go great with tea. She forgot. She likes Doctor Who, Sherlock, and Star Wars and art? Dude, it sounds like you could easily strike up a conversation with her about any of those things. There you go. And I'm sure you know a lot about them too. Dude, the first thing you gotta do is stop psyching yourself out. You're psyching yourself out by saying you got the social skills of a biscuit, but I would highly doubt that. I know you so far to be a creative and imaginative person, which I'm sure you have amazing conversational skills if you just know how to unlock them. And to unlock them, all you gotta do is start believing in yourself, stop dissing yourself, stop saying I got the social skills of a biscuit. Maybe you do, but you don't have to reinforce it. A girl who likes Star Wars is a keeper. That's right, man. Plan B, alcohol. Works every time, 98% of the time. Yeah, I probably should do that, huh? Okay, I'm gonna do a little bit of fade out to the top so I know about where it's like I don't need to work on it. Like about all of this stuff should just start fading out. Okay, I'm just gonna do one more pipe on the side. The same album, right? I love the same album too, man. God, there's a period of my life where I would listen to only the same album every day. Okay, I put these into a group. The pipe group. Pipes. And then duplicate it. Merge that copy. Flip it. And we'll have something for now. This is just a start to this artwork. I'm sure this will look a little bit better once it's all finished. Once I add the final touches and all that, this will look a lot better. But this is kind of cool to start with. See how this is looking. I'll probably do something similar for the bottom too. Yeah, they'll definitely be shade muteness, yeah. That's one of the little touches, right? The shadow, to put some shadow over the ones that are going over each other and stuff, that'll make it look a lot better. But as you can tell, you can't really even tell when you once it's in the game like this so far. And it needs to be the right color. Let's give it the right hue. I'm thinking it also is kind of this golden metal look. So we'll give it that hue. Wild Shadow, you made any of the sounds that Songbringer recording real life stuff? No, I haven't. All of them are all electronically generated. So I generate a lot of my sounds with a synthesizer called Massive. And I use Ableton also for generating sounds. And I also use this little program called Bufixer. So I generate a lot of sounds, but I haven't actually recorded any live sounds. I do a lot like... I use some free sounds, sound effects too. Whenever I want something that sounds like a real thing, I use freesound.org a lot. Okay, let's do something similar for the bottom. Foleys. Foleys are fun, right? Foley sound effects. Yep. It is really fun to make sound effects. If you just want to go and make sound effects, it can be super fun. Like, and if you watch a few, like, how to do some Foley sound effects, they're really not that difficult. Alright, so something similar to that, and I'll give some little edges to this, and bada bing, bada bam. Ah, oh, Rocket Bunny. All right, let's give this the right hue. Want to be similar. To, what's this? That's, I might use that actually. It's, 8 wall, here we go. This is about the right hue. Something like that for the highlights, but this for more of the general tones. See, more and more, this is getting to look like something kind of neat. I'm telling you, the last 20% of the art is just where it all pops. But we're not even anywhere near that. This is maybe only 50% done. 40%, maybe. Yeah, butter-flavored Kit Kats. Oh, we also need to fade out the bottom one. Let's do that. This is going to be quite a complex document. Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Ishii. We'll get there. Fade out. Fade out. I'll add a gradient layer. Getting a little better each step of the way. This is so weird how you can walk up there, but ignore the man behind the curtain. I'll make some collision areas so you can't throw your top hat inside it. Put some kind of crazy, something in the middle for sure. I wonder what would be the best thing. Nothing happens right now. You mean what should happen? Everything explodes. His afro, he doesn't have an afro. All right, we need a special, we need like one. This is gonna be crazy, but this is not doing it. We need a better way to do this gradient. So I'm gonna have to go pixel by pixel. Or so they think. Why does every Star Wars movie have a Death Star? Can somebody tell me? I'm kind of tired of the same plot every time. What if it has a giant alien fetus? Yeah. I don't know what goes inside the tube yet. Because of merchandise. Oh, is that it? Zilton, You're making a lot of sense today. Why have one Death Star? We have seven Death Stars. So for $29.99. Right, eight Death Stars. Upstream, I think it's uptime. Downstream, upstream. Think of all the good commands you can think of and try them all. Stream status. Stream add remote. Stream clone. Stream commit. Stream checkout. Wait, Git doesn't have a checkout, does it? Oh, it does have a checkout, yeah. Oh, it's not a Twitch command. It's a that's a bot foo command. It's a custom command. It's a bot foo is written by Boogie. You've seen Boogie on here before, I'm sure. Nuke points. Unbind all. Bot foo die. He responded to Rocket Bunny. All right, so I'm getting close to the end of the stream here. I haven't even gotten close to finishing this art yet, but so this might take another hour or two tonight. But once it's done, it's done. You know? It'll look good and stuff. There we go. Now we got that gradient looking pretty good. Pretty good. Rocket Bunny, you gave yourself points? Wait. Did that actually work? What was your points before? It didn't work. Oh man, I was kind of hoping you found a loophole. That would have been funny. There we go. Now that's looking better. The gradient. The gradient. The gradient. The gradient. The email. The email. What? The email. Hey, go get enter password. Pseudo RMRF. Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for saying happy Thanksgiving. So that's going to be the end of this stream, and I'm not going to be streaming this the rest of this week. I'll be on vacation visiting my family. So, see you, Ichni, and later, everybody. Have a great week. If you're having Thanksgiving this week, I hope you have a great Thanksgiving. If you're not, maybe if you're having a vacation, I hope you have a great vacation. Or if it's not even a vacation for you, I hope you have a great week anyways. All right? Yeah. So, yeah, cheers, everybody. I'll see you all next Monday or so. Have a good one.